Good morning, everyone. It's Tuesday, February 18, 2020. Jumada 2, day 23. Vlog number 1052. I'm studying and uploading the vlog from yesterday, so by the time you're watching this video, yesterday's vlog should already be up. Please be sure to go check it out. Don't forget to like, share, comment, and subscribe. So I'm getting the day started early. It's 10:30 in the morning, and I'm going to start the vlog in this hour. And now I have to go finish doing a little bit of laundry. So I'm going to go to my new place and go and do my laundry that I had sitting or whatever. Not looking forward to it because every time I get hyped up for some shit, it always just turns into a nightmare. Because I'll get really, really excited and then my mood will just be like, you're set up for failure, Sarah. So, any hoodens, I'm gonna go and do that and then, yeah. Pardon my hair. I'm hoping to do a couple of trips. I literally could not sleep because I was so excited. I didn't think excited would be the right term for it. It was more like, I couldn't sleep because I was just ready to get the hell out of here. Anyway. Where was I going? I was awake at like 2:30 in the morning and then I didn't go to sleep until like 4:30 in the morning. I don't even really remember. And then, cause I thought it was 6:00 in the morning or something, so I was just gonna get up and do like a early day and, just get started early on this stuff. Not that like there's even that much work. Well, it's not really work that I'm looking forward to because basically what's going to happen is I'm going to take like stuff over there, but then I'm just going to have to like unpack it over there. So it's like boring. I pretty much already put 2 trash bags of laundry into my car. I'm trying to think if there's anything else that I want to do right now. So probably not. So let's go to the new place and take care of the laundry at least. Because I'm gonna have to come back because I have to eat. So I'll come back and like make something for myself to eat when I come back. Because I'm going to get hungry and there's no food over there and I can't be like near a place that there's no food. Why is that? Just because I've got into a habit of actually eating more like an adult. Which is, I know it sounds kind of like stupid or vicious, but like when I was 17 or below, I used to really, really fast a lot, and like the Islamic way, which means like I wouldn't drink a lot of water and I didn't really like, I was very, very cautious about how much I actually ate. So, and then I'm also a health nut, so like salt was a big deal to me, sugar was a big deal, cholesterol. The other thing I do want to do is actually sweep over there. I think I'm going to try to get that done today as well, because something's got to be cleaned. It's either got to be here in this room or it's got to be that place, and I got to sweep in there because I have like allergy problems, and if like dust, if I breathe in any little bit of dust, I'll be really annoyed and I'll have to like take a shower to get it off. And, like, carbs was a really big deal. And, like, having been in America, like, pasta was just, like, the biggest thing to eat. And, like, I didn't eat pasta. So, because of my obsession with, like, not eating any carbs and consuming any carbs. So, yeah. So I would just, like, starve myself quite a bit. And then, like, I didn't eat Pakistani bread either because I just didn't like it. I hated it. It was all, like, plain and stuff. And I was like, I would tell my mom that I didn't really like the salt, so I didn't. So I just to kind of, like, argue with her, because she was, like, always insistent that I would eat something and whatnot. Just doing her motherly duties, I guess. And then, like, I was like, oh no, it has salt, I can't eat it. But I really just didn't like the taste of it. And it was just, like, way too much for me. I don't know if carbs are, like, fattening. I don't know if that's... Is that a correct fact? But I've never known. So, yeah. So, I was just, like... I don't know. I never really ate, like, carbs at all. I didn't like flour. I didn't even eat bread at my house. That was at my house. Like, I didn't eat pizza. I was sort of, in my childhood, to be honest, I was kind of against consumption of meat, which is unusual because I'm Muslim and Muslims are supposed to eat meat, but I was completely against the idea because it builds up cholesterol or something in your arteries, and that could lead to a heart attack. That's, like, once we were in the United States, and I was, like, how old was I? 6. I want to say I was 6 years old, so once I came into the U.S., I started doing that. But in Pakistan, like, as a kid, I used to always, I used to be normal. Normal in a sense in a Pakistani, like, you know, sense, like, the way that my mom would prefer, so I would eat whatever she made me, whether it was beef and vegetables or bread. I used to eat anything. Okay, and so the weather, or the climate, I should say, in these parts are, like, it's humid and it's hot at the same time, so it's, like, I'm sticky, and, I'm also, like, sweating at the same time, and, like, what do you call it? And it's humid outside, so it's, like, it's, like, makes my clothes, like, sag quite a bit, because it makes them all wet. I'm gonna open and empty out this closet, it's got, like, my shoe rack from IKEA in it, which would go really well in the closet, which is, it's, like, the little utility closet right inside my door. Got, like, a trash can in there I could take over there. But, yeah, I don't know if I should just wait to take it until later. And then there's my books, which are, like, super heavy. So if I have time, I'm gonna try to take those over there myself instead of having to, like, wait for the truck and then, like, put them onto the truck and then take them off the truck. I can just, like, keep them in my car, hopefully. They're kind of heavy, so it kind of, like, weighs down my car. But if I do that, then I can just, like, take one at a time, because the books will just get ruined if I put them on a moving truck. I know that for a fact, because they're so heavy, they'll just, like, fall out of the box, and, yeah. And my cat carrier is
My cat carriers are in that closet as well. I won't need them until like later.
Made it to the new place. Should I do a pop lock and drop it real quick? I don't know. I'm gonna fold some clothes and try to organize and set up my closet. Not as exciting as it sounds. I don't know what it is, but I feel like there's nothing like owning your own place, because I feel like I'm actually being able to squeeze through like the walls and stuff in the house here and like not hit my side or something. Whereas with, say for example, apartments, like it's just very, very congested, and like they're built like obviously for temporary, I think, but the spaces will be like way too small and I'll always hit something, and it's like, yeah. Actually, I have a vanity in this place, so now I can actually look and see what I look like when I'm getting dressed in the morning. I put off getting a shower caddy, so I definitely need a shower caddy. Just go ahead and make another trip and get the microwave and my toaster oven and my coffee maker, because of all the congestion, I haven't really been able to have like a decent cup of coffee in weeks. It's just in forever, I shouldn't say weeks. The thing I can go ahead and start bringing over is my medicine stuff. Some of it, at least. I have a lot. So we're gonna trip out to the place. Now I'm gonna go back and see what's up to the squirrel. I had to drop off a load of laundry and put that in, and so put in some laundry, and I switched out the stuff that was already done from the washer to the dryer. Dropped off the broom, dropped off a bunch of medicine stuff. You live at home with your mama. Oh yes, son. I'm talking to me with no money. Oh no, I don't wanna go.
You in a class with scrubs, never rising. I don't find it surprising if you don't have the G's to please me and bounce from here to the coast of overseas. So, let me give you something to think about.
I made ramen that's soy and sriracha sauce with 3 eggs. I was looking at the computer and then I turned around and I saw this. Right in the center. Anyways, you guys, I'm gonna close the vlog. Please don't forget to like, share, comment, and subscribe, and I will talk to you guys on the next vlog.